Hi, I'm Peter Efforts, a professional research assistant with the Cooperative Institute for Research in Environmental Sciences working in NOAA's Global Monitoring Laboratory. Today I'm going to show you the Dobson Ozone Laboratory and World Calibration Facility. This is the laboratory where NOAA calibrates and maintains a number of Dobson ozone spectrophotometers. The Dobson ozone spectrophotometer uses sunlight to measure total column ozone. The Dobson compares two wavelengths of sunlight to derive the amount of ozone in the column of air above it. This lab is used for repairs, calibration, and maintenance of the Dobson instrument. Part of that process is known as the standard lamp test. NOAA and Ceres scientists use lamps that emit light at known frequencies and intensities to ensure the instrument is measuring light properly. The Dobson technology will be turning 100 years old next year, and the instrument that NOAA uses have been in use since the 1960s. Although the instrument technology is old by today's standards, the instrument is still considered one of the most stable ground-based measurements for measuring total column ozone. NOAA's network includes 14 sites around the world, including at the South Pole, where the Dobson, along with the ozone sondes, were instrumental in the discovery of the ozone hole. Since 1980, this facility has been designated by the World Meteorological Organization as the World Calibration Facility for the Dobson, meaning every Dobson measurement around the world is calibrated to this world reference, Dobson number 83, shown here. On the roof of the David Skaggs Research Center is the Dobson Dome, which houses a Dobson instrument for total column ozone measurements. Measurements are taken three times a day at 10 a.m., noon, and 2 p.m. A NOAA scientist will come to the dome, take one zenith sky measurement, which means looking straight up, and one direct sun measurement. For the zenith sky measurement, the hatch at the top of the dome is opened and the measurement is taken. Then the dome door is opened and the sun director is placed on top of the instrument to direct the sunlight down into the instrument. These measurements are saved to a computer and evaluated by scientists to determine the long-term trends and changes to the global total column ozone.